In this video, we're going to walk through the logic of defining a line in space using vector-valued functions. So to start out, let L be the line that passes through the fixed point P0, which you'll see in my picture here, fixed point P0, and it's at the point x0, y0, z0, and in the direction of a vector v, given by the components ABC. So here we're just defining a line by a point and a direction. So for this fixed point P0, I'm just going to draw in the associated position vector, and we're going to call that R0. Now we could also call this vector R0 vector OP0 because it runs between the origin and the point P0. And the components of this vector are x0, y0, z0. So far at this point, we have a fixed point P0, and then a direction that define our line L. So next, let's consider a variable or movable point on our line L and call it P, and it's going to be at the point XYZ. Now we'll call the associated position vector for this point vector R or vector OP, since it's going to run between the origin and point P. So we see that vector R, or vector OP, has components XYZ. Now there's not enough room to draw it on this picture, but let's consider the vector P0, P. That is the vector that runs between the points P0 and P. So we can see that this vector P0, P is in the same direction as our vector V. Okay? So then what I can do is I can write vector P0, P equals T times vector V. So that is, a vector P0, P is some scalar multiple of vector V. Now by using vector addition, we can convince ourselves of the following fact. Vector OP equals vector OP0 plus vector P0P. Now you can convince yourself of this fact if you remember the triangle rule for adding vectors. So I'm saying vector OP0, which is this vector in purple, plus vector P0P, which isn't shown in my picture, but it goes along here between points P0 and P. The addition of those vectors equals a pink vector, vector OP. So then, using this fact that we just wrote, the vector P0P equals T times V, then I could write this as vector OP equals vector OP0 plus T times vector V. And there are actually a few other ways we can write this relationship. We could write it like this in component form. Vector XYZ equals vector X0, Y0, Z0 plus T times vector ABC. Or another way we could write this is vector R equals vector R0 plus T times vector V. And actually, these formulas give an equation of the line in space passing through the fixed point P0 and in the direction of vector V. So if you like to think in terms of parametric equations, we can also equate the components of the vector and write the parametric equation. So that would be x equals x0 plus at, y equals y0 plus bt, and then z equals z0 plus ct for t between negative infinity and positive infinity. So we see that the parameter t determines where we are along this line, and as t varies over all the real numbers from negative infinity to infinity, this entire line will be swept out. So in just a minute, you'll have the opportunity to view some examples of how to use this information to determine the equation of a line in space.